Welcome back. You're watching Headlines Now. It's yet another Facebook controversy. Vaseline's face whitening application on Facebook, which lets users upload photos to make them fairer, has been termed racist. Vaseline launched the application Transform Your Face on Facebook to promote its range of skin lightening products for men, advertised by Bollywood star Shahid Kapoor. It enables users to digitally whiten their profile pictures and remove dark spots, an idea that has evoked a largely negative response in the blogosphere since news broke early this week. The meet between foreign ministers of India and Pakistan in Islamabad today showed positive signs. Pakistan Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi is likely to visit India later this year to continue dialogue with his counterpart S.M. Krishna. The two foreign ministers held extensive talks today that, according to sources, were marked by constructive candor. The two ministers are likely to hold a joint press conference later today after S.M. Krishna's meetings with Pakistan President Asif Ali Zardari and Prime Minister Gilani. Moving down south, in a major victory for activists against a power plant in Andhra's Srikakulam district, the National Environment Appellate Authority has overruled the environment clearance project given by the Nagarjuna group yesterday. Two people were killed in the violent protests against the power plant. NDTV's T.S. Sudhir joins us with more.
The National Appellate Authority for Environment really has castigated the government for grossly misrepresenting the facts before the Appellate Authority, also saying that the area has serious wetland characteristics and it will also affect the livelihood of villagers, fisherfolk in that area of Sompeta in Srikakulam district of Andhra Pradesh, and that the government should seriously consider all these aspects before allowing any more thermal projects in that area. Now, what happens to the other three thermal projects which are slated to come up in Srikakulam district? Two of them are in fact in the Naupada swamps and one of them in the Ichapuram lagoon area, all wetlands area which environmentalists say will seriously impact the ecologically fragile environment of Srikakulam district.
On a proud moment for India, the national currency note, the rupee, will now have a symbol quite like the dollar, euro or the pound sterling. So you can see that sign soon on your keyboards as well. A 5-man jury picked the symbol from the shortlist from an All India competition. The symbol finally chosen was submitted by an IIT postgraduate, Uday Kumar.
This symbol are announcing that the Indian currency has arrived on the international platform. And it would also distinguish our currency from other countries which also use either the rupee or the rupiah or something similar. Ours would be, this would make ours distinguish ours.
NDTV also caught up with Uday Kumar, the proud designer of that rupee symbol. He's an IIT postgraduate from Bombay. It's a double celebration for him as he will also be joining IIT Guwahati as an assistant professor tomorrow.
How does this symbol, how does it reflect Indian ethos and culture?
This is a Devanagari Ra, because, and if you look at Indian, all the scripts in the world, only Devanagari Ra has a Shiroreka, which is the top line, which is unique to the Indian scripts. No other scripts in the world has that. So that way, an Indian, using an Indian script is actually making it an Indian, Indianness.
Indianizing the symbol as much as possible.
Yes, all right. You're right.
And then something about the flag in this?
Yes. I put a horizontal line in between the R so that we get a tricolor. If you see the symbol, the space between them, between the two lines acts as a white space, so it makes a tricolor flag. So I wanted our flag to fly high and also be represented in the symbol. So way it becomes a more Indian symbol.
There were 5 finalists.
Yes.
So what's it for the future then?
Future, now I've gotten a job at IIT Guwahati, so I'll be joining as an assistant professor in IIT Guwahati tomorrow, so I'm leaving to IIT Guwahati.
Well, on to some cricket controversies. Looks like the suspended IPL chief will have to face it. The Bombay High Court has dismissed Lalit Modi's petition to impose a stay order on the July 16th disciplinary committee hearing. The BCCI disciplinary committee, comprising of Arun Jaitley, Jyotiraditya Scindia and Chirayu Amin, had summoned Lalit Modi for a hearing scheduled tomorrow, following which Modi petitioned the Bombay High Court to stay the meeting and instead establish an independent and impartial inquiry panel with a judicial presence. Modi's arguments have clearly gone, however, unheard with this ruling today, and he will have to attend that meeting tomorrow. So, ace Indian badminton player Saina Nehwal became the new world number 2 in the latest ranking released by the Badminton World Federation on Thursday. After winning 3 successive international tournaments, Saina Nehwal is confident of conquering the next month's World Championship in Paris.
It's an individual event finally, you know, we're not playing cricket or hockey to be a captain over there. But yeah, you know, I can just motivate them saying that, you know, work hard and give your best over there. But finally, it's my own event which I have to focus on and I have to really work on my event.
Right.
Now, the landmark judgment of the first commercial flight of an A380, the world's largest passenger aircraft to India, has landed in New Delhi. The Emirates A380 Super Jumbo EK516 from Dubai to Delhi arrived at Indira Gandhi International Airport's brand new Terminal 3. The aircraft will be at the IGI airport for 3 hours before it returns to Dubai.
We're on board the first commercial Airbus A380 flight into the new Terminal 3 of Indira Gandhi International Airport. It is, in a sense, a bit of a landmark. Terminal 3 is all about the future of Indian aviation. Millions of passengers are going to be going through this new terminal, considered among the finest and most advanced in the world. And the aircraft I'm on, an Airbus A380, is, in a sense, a revolution in transport for civilian passengers all over the world. We are on the second deck of this Emirates A380. I'm in front of the bar of the first and business class passengers. And this really adds a great extent to the experience of traveling. This is the new style of traveling in a new generation of aircraft where passenger comfort and, of course, passenger safety remains a huge priority.
Robots often attract the attention of both children and adults, but their study is considered quite abstract. But imagine having to study robotics at school. For the first time, a school here in Chennai has introduced robotics as a regular subject in their curriculum, triggering interest in children and parents alike. Bertila reports.
Huzaifa loves to operate his gadgets at home, and there are many others like him. But now, even classrooms could become a fun place after a school in Chennai decides to make lessons in robotics a regular feature.
On TV, I saw a robot which was moving on its own. Like, it was a humanoid robot. It was designed in a way of a human. The name of the robot was Asima. So that was the thing that inspired me to make this robot. And I look forward to make the same robot which was made, which I saw on TV.
At the Caliber Academy, students between the ages of 6 and 14 years, like Huzaifa, will attend classes in what is called classical robotics, where they learn to build models, attach sensors and motors, and then configure them with simple programming tools in the computer. Educators feel lessons like these will mark a landslide shift in the way children receive education in school.
And what are all our machines that we use? But things that don't speak, but part of robotics. So it's not something alien, it's very much a part and parcel of your life. So I said, if it's a part and parcel of our lives, then we have to make it a part and parcel of the curriculum. And we've integrated this to the math, the numeracy and the science curriculum. We're not going to stop with it. We're hoping to integrate it with the art, the literacy, the sport, the physical education, the dance, music curriculum as well, because we know this is the way forward.
But robotic science sounds like an expensive thing to learn. But Caliber Academy says the fee is affordable and parents are not expected to turn away. In Chennai, Bertila, NDTV Hindu.
And finally, when we think of heritage, we think of all that was colonial or medieval. But what about those little places in Chennai that have become the object of neglect in the wake of the IT boom? NDTV Hindu stumbles upon a post office as enchanting as it's frightening, a place that begs to be called a part of Chennai's heritage because such places never knew their functional utility would be overshadowed by the futuristic appeal of everything IT.
When the sun goes down, this place rises. For the last 7 years, no human has set foot inside this building. Once a post office serving tiny hamlets in pre-IT boom Perangadi. Now, according to locals, this has become a playground for evil spirits. NDTV Hindu's cameras try to enter this place. Every attempt marred by fear as darkness comes calling. A strange sound emanates from the well. Soon, fear gets the better of NDTV Hindu's cameraman.
You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time.
One who has seen this place go from Perangadi's pride to an ignored piece of heritage is this man. Benny is the man who will lead NDTV Hindu's cameras into a place no human has entered for the last 10 years. Once inside, a miserable sight. Broken rusted chairs, collapsed roofs. The postmaster's chair still lies where it used to. Now it's posed to elements. Snails cover the floor, dead meat for snakes and bats that prowl around. One wrong step and it's certain death. A peep inside the window. It seems something has looked into the eye of the camera and the cameraman. Now look at this again from behind the back of the lensman. As we approach, the door moves on its own and we scamper to safety. But even fear has reason and Benny shows us the way.
This is one of the oldest building in Perangudi. The IT boom, the four lanes, and the concrete jungle. Perangudi is searching for its old soul, just as this building, so was I, as an old resident of Perangudi.
Once a post office that delivered letters to villages, hamlets that have now become extinct in the glass and glitter of an IT revolution. People have forgotten the historic significance of this post office. No wonder this place preserves its own heritage through fear. With Arun, Simonish for NDTV Hindu.
Alright, that's all we have for you now. News and updates will continue in Tamil. Thanks for watching.